students in online class for the subject physics for standard 12th science. So today we have to learn chapter number 14, dual nature of radiation and matter. So today we have seen de Broglie's hypothesis. In 1924, Louis de Broglie proposed on the basis of symmetry existing in nature that if radiation has dual nature, dual nature means particle nature as well as wave nature, then sometimes wave nature dominates and sometimes particle nature dominates. So matter may also possess dual nature. Normally we talk about the matter as composed of particle, but there is a situation where seems to show like wave properties. This will be shown from the experiment on diffraction of electrons from nickel crystal. Diffractions of electron from nickel crystal. De Broglie used properties of frequency. If frequency of incident radiation will be nu and wavelength of incident light will be lambda, then of wave. So proposed relation between energy and momentum. We know that energy, according to Einstein's mass energy relation, energy is equal to mc square, means is equal to mc into c. So that will be mc is linear momentum into velocity of light will be energy, and therefore p is equal to e upon c. Suppose this is equation number 1. See here, energy will be m into c square, so is equal to m into c into c. So m into c will be momentum, mass into velocity, and so that energy equal to momentum into velocity, and therefore momentum is equal to energy upon velocity, and therefore we know that according to Planck's quantum theory, energy is equal to h nu, and therefore p is equal to h nu upon c. We know that the relation between velocity, frequency and wavelength. So velocity is equal to frequency gunile wave multiplied by wavelength. Therefore nu is equal to c upon lambda, and therefore we can taken as h c upon lambda into c. Cc get cancel, and therefore p is equal to h upon lambda, and this is the formula for de Broglie's proposed, and therefore de Broglie's wavelength, it will be from this formula we can calculate that de Broglie's wavelength will be lambda is equal to h upon p. For a moving particle whose total energy is E and momentum is P, associated with a wave. This analogous to a photon. So therefore, de Broglie proposed that or suggested that wave and particle. Wave and particle properties of matter. Can also described by relation P equal to H upon lambda. Therefore, we know that if M is mass of particle which is moving with velocity V. So momentum M into V is equal to H upon lambda, or which is equal to H upon P. Therefore, we can say that lambda is equal to H upon P or H upon MV. Using this relation, we can say that lambda is inversely proportional to momentum, means wavelength is inversely proportional to momentum, or momentum is inversely proportional to wavelength. The wavelength is called as de Broglie's wavelength. Another way we can see that, we know that if kinetic energy of particle having mass m and velocity v, we know that it will be half m v square. Therefore, we can written as E equal to half m v square multiplied to, so we say that m v square is equal to 2 times E, and therefore v square is equal to twice of E divided by m. And if we take square root on both sides, therefore we say that V is equal to square root of 2 times E upon small m. Suppose this is equation number 2 or equation number A. This is taken as equation number A. We know that from de Broglie's wavelength, lambda is equal to H upon M. Value of V, it will be lambda is equal to H upon M square root of 2 times kinetic energy upon small m. If M is taken in square root, then we can written as H upon square root of M square multiplied by 2E upon M. M get cancel. So we can taken as H upon square root of 2 times M into E. That will be wavelength. So here, if we know energy of electron is measured in electron volt, if small e is charge of electron, then we, according to photoelectric effect, we say that kinetic energy of electron, it will be E into V, or it will be E into stopping potential. So that we can taken as value of E, it will be written as lambda is equal to H upon square root of 2 times mass into energy charge into stopping potential. V0 or V. That is where V0 is stopping potential. Potential or potential. So what happened? We know that the value of M and value of E. We know value of M, that is mass of electron, it will be 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. And value of E, it will be 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So if and value of H, it will be 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 13 4 joule second. If we multiply and divide the constant value, then we can say that lambda is equal to H divided by square root of 2 multiplied by M multiplied by E into 1 upon square root of V0 or V. If we can find out the value of bracket, the value of bracket will be find out using, see here, using lambda is equal to 6.63 divided into 10 to the power minus 34 divided by square root of 2 into 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 19 into 10 raised to minus 31 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 multiplied by 1 upon square root of V0. What happened? So here it can clearly written as 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 divided by square root of 2 multiplied by 14.56 into 10 to the power minus 40. If we can multiply here 14.56 into 2, then we can take as 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 divided by square root of 29.12 into 10 to the power minus, sorry, it is 10 to the power minus 50. So we can written as 10 to the power minus 50. So here upon 5.396 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 34 upon 10 to the power minus 50 minus 25. So if 10 to the power minus 25 is on numerator, so here 6.63 upon 5.396 into 10 to the power, so we can take as minus 25 will be plus 25, and plus 25 it will be taken as minus 9. It will be taken as minus, so it will be seen logarithm of 0 point here, characteristics 0 point subtraction 66 in 3, that will be 8215, and 53 in 9, 6 will be mean difference, that will be 7321. So if we subtract from 5, 1 will be subtract, 4 is remaining. From 11, 2 will be subtract, 9 will be remaining. From 12, 4 is subtract, 8 will be remaining. From 8, 8 will be subtract, 1, 0 will be remaining, and 0. If we take antilog for 0.08 in 9, 4 is in mean difference, then we say that 0.08 in 9, that will be 1227, and in 6 it will be 2, that is 1.229 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. divided by square root of potential, that is stopping potential. Square root of potential, that is stopping potential. Sometimes 10 raised to minus 9, it will also taken as in nanometer. So we say that de Broglie's wavelength will be lambda is equal to 1.229 divided by square root of V0 nanometer. Or sometimes we can taken as if decimal point is shifted 0.1229 divided by square root of V0 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So wavelength, de Broglie's wavelength, it will be 0.1229 square root of V0 angstrom unit. Using this formula, we can calculate as de Broglie's wavelength. Shortly, there is existence of photon. It is experimentally found that electron subatomic and atomic particle like photon and neutrons are also shows their wave properties. But wave properties of electron, or therefore wave properties of electron, was confirmed experimentally in Davison and Germer's experiment. Using this, later on, de Broglie's hypothesis, then the subatomic particles will behave as wave, so that these subatomic particles behaves as a wave. But here photoelectric emission, it will shows particle nature. So later on in next video we have to see in wave particle duality of matter.